A lot of this racism is making me very insecure, I'm not going to lie. Not so much the obvious in-your-face racism. I think that's, in some ways, a bit easier to deal with. More like social conditioning. Like, you never see people who look like me advertising anything sexy in this country. We're never the Diet Coke guy, we're never the milk tray man. Like, miss, when you're picturing a hot Asian, in your head, you've got a Vindaloo, aren't you, mate? Not one of these lads. The other thing that's making me insecure is my position in comedy. Because once I've defeated Islamophobia after everyone's seen this show, what do I joke about next? My nephew tried to help me out, bless him. I was writing this show around his a few months ago, and he came up to me, bundle of energy, and he goes, Uncle, my friend Johnny, that's my best friend in nursery, he told me a joke. can I tell you a joke, please? Oh, okay, be quick. Johnny said, what did the fishy say when it swam in a wall? I don't know that one. What did he say? Damn. And it did annoy me, because it did make me laugh. And then he goes, Johnny said you can put that in your show. Did he? Oh, how generous of Johnny. I can't put that in my show, can I? That's not one of Johnny's jokes, is it? His mum or dad told him that. It's not a Johnny original, is it? I can't do cover jokes. Right, that's not how this stuff works. People expect original material. My niece was in the room. She didn't understand what I meant. She explained to me that her favourite singer at the moment is Ariana Grande. And as well as being an amazing original artist, Ariana Grande is also apparently amazing at doing covers, which I don't understand. I don't understand why you people are so impressed by what is essentially professional karaoke. Why does that make you people so wet? Singing, that is the only industry you can do that in. Mark, if you're a student, you can't hand a thesis to your lecturer and be like, oh, there's my cover of Einstein's Theory of Relativity. Enjoy that, mate, while I go get drunk. I explained to them that my favourite comedian of all time is Chris Rock. Obviously, they don't know who Chris Rock is. I explained to them my favourite Chris Rock routine of all time is N-words versus black people. Obviously, you might not know the routine. You know what I mean when I say N-words, though. Obviously, I can't say the N-word. I'm not an American police officer. If you don't know the routine, pause this now. YouTube, Chris Rock, N-words versus black people. I can't do that. I can't come out here and be like, oh, guys, I love Asians, but I hate Pakis. Boy, I hate Pakis. Boy, I would join the EDL. Shit, I do a drive-by from here to Bradford. I can't do that. Do you know how hard it is to get guns in this country? It is impossible. Explain that to my niece and nephew. My niece nodded like she understood. My nephew, he didn't say anything, but he just gave me a look, which I kind of interpreted as, Uncle, don't you think you're gonna have to compromise on your art in order to be commercially successful? It's like you said, if you can't beat them, join them. All right. On his advice, I wrote a joke. Mark, what would you call an Asian archaeologist? Indian Jones? And that's why I write the shows that I write.